Welcome to Adult Sleep Stories. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury, but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies, and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. The Phantom Island in the Indian Ocean. Chapter 1. The Mysterious Island. In the heart of the vast Indian Ocean, a mystery as old as the sea itself whispered among sailors and adventurers. It was the legend of a phantom island, an enigmatic landmass that appeared and disappeared without warning or pattern. This legend, shrouded in mystery and allure, had become the focus of many tales told on moonlit decks across the ocean. The story begins in a bustling port, where a group of sailors, led by the seasoned Captain John Avery and his skilled first mate, Jackie Lou, prepare for an extraordinary voyage. Their ship, a sturdy vessel named the Mariner's Hope, stood ready to embark on a journey into the unknown. The crew, a diverse and spirited group, were busy loading supplies, securing ropes, and performing final checks. Captain Avery, a man who had spent his life chasing horizons, felt a special kind of excitement about this journey. Rumors of the Phantom Island had reached his ears many times, and he had always dismissed them as seafarers' fables. But something, perhaps the allure of the unexplained or the call of adventure, had finally convinced him to seek the truth. Jackie Lou, the first mate, shared his captain's enthusiasm but approached the journey with a rational mind. He carefully studied maps and charts, noting that the island, if it existed, was not marked on any of them. His expertise in navigation would be crucial in navigating the treacherous waters of the Indian Ocean. The crew bid farewell to the spectators gathered at the port as the ship sailed away. The sky above was a dome of limitless possibilities, and the sea in front of us was a canvas of rich blue. Their early days on the journey were characterized by calm sailing and a strong sense of companionship. The crew was full with anticipation and worked like a well-oiled machine. However, as they ventured further into the ocean, unusual occurrences began to unfold. The weather, usually predictable in these parts, turned erratic. Sudden squalls would be followed by unnerving calms, and the sun seemed to play hide and seek behind unnatural clouds. One night, as the ship sailed under a blanket of stars, an old sailor named Thomas gathered the crew on deck. In a voice weathered by salt and wind, he told an ancient mariner's tale about the Phantom Island. He spoke of a cursed ship, doomed to guard a hidden treasure, and warned of the peril that befell those who sought the island. His tale added a chilling dimension to their quest and left the crew in silent contemplation. Jackie, always the skeptic, dismissed the tale as mere superstition. But even he couldn't ignore the strange happenings that began to occur. Their compasses spun wildly, the stars seemed to shift in the night sky, and the sea life around them behaved peculiarly. Bioluminescent creatures painted the sea in otherworldly colors, and eerie fog banks appeared out of nowhere. Communications with the mainland were kept up by Dr. Emily Harrows, a meteorologist who had taken an interest in their expedition. Her analysis of the weather patterns provided some scientific insight, but even she admitted that there were anomalies she couldn't explain. As they sailed deeper into the region where the island was rumored to be, a palpable tension settled over the mariner's hope. The crew took turns keeping watch, eyes straining through spyglasses, hoping to be the first to spot the elusive land. Then, on a night shrouded in fog, as the ship cut through the silent waters, a lookout's shout pierced the air. "Land ahead," he cried, pointing towards a shape emerging from the mist. The crew rushed to the deck, hearts racing with a mix of fear and excitement. As the fog cleared, a shadowy outline of land became visible, hinting that perhaps the legend of the Phantom Island was more than just a tale. Chapter 2. The Quest Begins. As the dawn broke over the Indian Ocean, the silhouette of the mysterious island loomed on the horizon, shrouded in a veil of mist. Aboard the Mariner's Hope, Captain John Avery and his crew stared in awe at the sight that many had deemed a sailor's fable. The island, with its rugged cliffs and lush greenery, was a stark contrast to the endless blue expanse they had traversed. The atmosphere on the ship was electric with excitement and apprehension. First Mate Jackie Liu, with his eyes fixed on the island, began coordinating the approach. The crew, seasoned by many voyages, worked with precision, adjusting sails and plotting the course. Despite their experience, an air of uncertainty hung over them, the weight of the unknown pressing heavily on their minds. As they neared the island, Dr. Emily Harrows sent through her final message before they lost signal. She warned them of unpredictable weather patterns around the island and advised extreme caution. Her words, a blend of scientific concern and genuine fear, added to the tense atmosphere. Captain Avery convened a meeting with his senior crew members. They discussed their strategy for exploring the island, emphasizing safety and the need for constant vigilance. The captain's voice was firm yet reassuring, instilling a sense of confidence in his crew. They knew the risks, but were driven by the desire to unravel the mystery of the Phantom Island. The ship anchored off the coast, and a smaller rowboat was prepared for the shore party. Captain Avery, Jackie, and a select group of crew members armed themselves with supplies and equipment. As they rowed towards the island, the reality of their situation set in. They were about to set foot on a land that might have been untouched for centuries. Upon landing, they found themselves on a beach of fine white sand, fringed by dense jungle. The air was thick with the scent of exotic flora, and the sound of unseen creatures echoed through the trees. The team started their exploration, marking their path to ensure a safe return to the shore. The island was a labyrinth of natural wonders, towering trees, hidden waterfalls, and exotic wildlife. The deeper they ventured, the more they realized that the island was not just a geographical anomaly, but a place shrouded in a deeper mystery. As they explored, they stumbled upon ancient ruins overgrown with vegetation. Intricate carvings on stone structures depicted scenes of maritime journeys and celestial bodies, suggesting that the island had once been visited, or perhaps even inhabited, long ago. Jackie, with his keen eye for detail, noticed a pattern in the carvings that resembled a map. They followed the clues, leading them to a cave hidden behind a waterfall. Inside, they discovered walls adorned with more carvings and inscriptions in a language none of them recognized. The cave was a treasure trove of artifacts, old navigational instruments, coins from different eras, and remnants of what appeared to be a shipwreck. It was clear that they were not the first to find the island, but the fate of those who came before remained a mystery. As the day turned to evening, the team decided to set up camp on the beach. The night on the island was a symphony of unfamiliar sounds, from the rustling of leaves to the distant cries of nocturnal animals. The crew members took turns keeping watch, the fire casting dancing shadows on their faces. Meanwhile, back on the ship, the remaining crew members kept a vigilant eye on the surrounding waters. The sea around the island seemed calm, but they knew better than to trust appearances in these uncharted territories. That night, Captain Avery pondered the day's discoveries. The island was more than just a phantom, it was a keeper of secrets, of stories long lost to the ocean's depths. The ancient ruins and the artifacts they found hinted at a past intertwined with the sea, and he couldn't help but feel that they were on the brink of a significant discovery. However, alongside the excitement, there was an undeniable sense of foreboding. The legends of the cursed ship and the warnings in Dr. Harrow's messages lingered in his mind. The island, for all its beauty, held an air of danger. As the first rays of sunlight broke the darkness, the crew awoke to another day of exploration, unaware of the challenges and revelations that awaited them. Their journey into the heart of the Phantom Island had only just begun, and the secrets it held were yet to be fully uncovered. Chapter 3: Secrets of the Deep. The morning sun rose over the Phantom Island, casting its golden light on the mariner's Hope and her crew, who had begun another day of exploration. The island, with its untamed beauty, seemed to awaken alongside them, revealing more of its secrets under the new day's light. Captain John Avery, Jackie Lou, and their team ventured deeper into the island's heart, driven by the discoveries they had made the day before. The island was like a living puzzle, each piece leading to another, each clue opening a new path to explore. The dense jungle that blanketed much of the island was both a hindrance and a source of wonder. Exotic birds flew overhead, their colorful plumage a stark contrast against the green canopy. Strange fruits and flowers adorned the trees, some with enticing scents, others with ominous appearances. The team made notes and sketches, documenting everything that could give insight into the island's unique ecosystem. As they traversed the rugged terrain, they stumbled upon a series of narrow trails that crisscrossed the jungle. These paths, seemingly man-made, suggested that the island had once been home to a civilization long forgotten. The team followed these trails, which led them to new discoveries. One such path took them to a cliff overlooking the ocean. Here, they found carvings on the rocks that depicted stars and constellations, some of which were unfamiliar to them. Jackie, with her knowledge of astronomy, speculated that these might be ancient navigational guides, perhaps used by sailors or explorers who visited the island centuries ago. The exploration continued, with each step revealing more about the island's mysterious past. They found remnants of what appeared to be dwellings, stone foundations overgrown with vines, pottery shards scattered among the foliage and tools made from bone and stone. Amidst these ruins, they discovered a peculiar stone structure, half buried under the earth. Carefully excavating around it, they unearthed a stone chest, its surface etched with symbols similar to those in the cave. Inside, they found scrolls made of a material they couldn't identify, preserved remarkably well. The scrolls were covered in the same unknown language as the cave inscriptions, suggesting a link between the two. As they delved further into the island, the sense of being watched grew stronger. Unseen eyes seemed to follow their every move, and more than once, they thought they heard whispers in the wind. The island held a presence that was almost palpable, a silent observer to their intrusion. The most startling discovery came when they reached the heart of the island. There, hidden in a secluded valley, was a lake of crystal clear water, its surface reflecting the lush surroundings like a mirror. In the center of the lake, partially submerged, lay the remains of a ship, its mast broken, its sails long gone, but its structure remarkably intact. The sight of the ship sent a chill down their spines. It was as if they had stumbled upon a scene frozen in time, a ghostly reminder of the island's storied past. The team carefully approached the wreckage, noting its design and construction, which pointed to an era long past. Exploring the ship, they found it eerily preserved. Personal belongings were still in place, maps and charts lay scattered, and a captain's log rested on the decaying desk. The log's pages, though faded, told a tale of a voyage gone awry, a crew plagued by strange illnesses, and a captain obsessed with a treasure he believed was hidden on the island. As night fell, the crew returned to their camp, minds swirling with the day's discoveries. The ship in the lake was a significant find, but it also raised more questions than it answered. Who were these sailors? What had brought them to the island? And what had happened to them? Back on the Mariner's Hope, the crew shared their findings with the rest of the team. The atmosphere was one of excitement mixed with unease. The island was revealing its secrets, but each answer led to deeper mysteries. The ancient ruins, the stone carvings, the ship in the lake, all pointed to a history that was complex and, perhaps, ominous. That night, as the crew rested, their dreams were filled with images of the island, the ruins, the ship, the silent gaze of the unseen watchers. The island, for all its natural beauty, held a haunting presence, a sense of something ancient and unknowable. The next morning, as they prepared for another day of exploration, Captain Avery and his team knew that they were on the cusp of a great discovery. The island, with its hidden ship and mysterious past, was more than just a phantom in the ocean. It was a keeper of stories, a guardian of secrets long buried in the depths of time. Chapter 4. The Curse Unveiled. The dawn on the Phantom Island was a palette of vibrant colors, painting the sky in hues of orange and pink. The Mariner's Hope crew, now deeply entrenched in the island's mysteries, prepared for what they hoped would be a day of significant revelations. Captain John Avery, Jackie Lou, and their exploration team set out to investigate the ship they had discovered in the lake. The ship, a relic of a bygone era, seemed to be the key to understanding the island's past. The captain's log they had found hinted at a treasure and a curse, elements of old sailors' tales, yet they couldn't dismiss them as mere fiction. As they approached the ship, an inexplicable sense of dread settled over them. The air around the ship was cooler, and a silence pervaded the area, as if even the island itself was holding its breath. The team boarded the vessel cautiously, aware that they might be disturbing a resting place of souls long gone. Inside the ship, they found more clues. The captain's quarters held maps with the island marked prominently, and notes scribbled in the margins spoke of a hidden cavern where the treasure was supposedly hidden. These findings confirmed their suspicion that the ship's crew had been consumed by their quest for this treasure. The exploration took a turn when they discovered a hidden compartment in the captain's cabin. Inside, there were several artifacts, including a locket with an intricately carved symbol that matched the symbols found on the stone chest and cave walls. This connection between the ship and the island's earlier inhabitants was a significant piece of the puzzle. As the day progressed, the team explored the rest of the island, following the map from the captain's quarters. Their search led them to a part of the island they hadn't yet explored, a dense forest on the far side of the island, where the trees seemed to close in around them, casting long shadows on their path. In the heart of the forest, they found the entrance to a cavern, just as depicted in the captain's notes. The entrance was overgrown with vines, and the air was thick with the smell of earth and decay. With torches in hand, they ventured inside, the light casting eerie shadows on the walls. The cavern was a labyrinth of tunnels and chambers, each leading deeper into the heart of the island. The walls were lined with more carvings, and in the deepest chamber, they found it, a treasure trove that surpassed all their wildest dreams. Gold and jewels glittered in their torchlight, artifacts from different cultures and eras lay scattered around, and in the center of the room, an altar with an obsidian stone that pulsed with a strange inner light. As they stood in awe of their discovery, the air in the chamber shifted, and a ghostly figure materialized before them. It was the spectral captain of the ship, his expression tormented. In a voice that echoed through the chamber, he recounted his tale, a tale of greed and a curse that bound him and his crew to the island for eternity. The captain had sought the treasure, ignoring the warnings of the island's guardians. In his greed, he had unleashed a curse that trapped his soul and those of his crew, condemning them to guard the treasure they had so desperately sought. The ghostly captain implored the crew of the Mariner's Hope to leave the treasure untouched, warning that the curse would claim them as well. His words were a chilling reminder of the dangers of greed and the price of disturbing the resting places of the past. The team, shaken by this encounter, debated their next course of action. Captain Avery, realizing the gravity of the situation, decided to heed the spectral captain's warning. They took only the captain's log and the locket as evidence of their discovery, leaving the treasure and the island's secrets undisturbed. As they made their way back to the ship, the island seemed to react to their decision. The air lightened, the eerie feeling that had followed them dissipated, and for the first time since they had arrived, the island felt at peace. Back on the Mariner's Hope, the crew weighed anchor, setting their course back to the mainland. As the island faded into the horizon, they knew they were leaving behind a story that would become part of maritime legend. They had uncovered the truth about the Phantom Island, a truth that was far more complex and haunting than any of them had imagined. The return journey was a time for reflection. They had ventured into the unknown, face the mysteries of the past and come face to face with the consequences of human greed. The island had changed them, each in their own way, leaving an indelible mark on their souls. As they docked at the port from where they had embarked on their journey, their story of the Phantom Island was met with disbelief by some and all by others. But for Captain Avery and his crew, the experience was a reminder of the mysteries that lay hidden in the vast oceans of the world, waiting to be discovered, yet warning of the perils of disturbing the secrets that were meant to remain hidden.